The United States Navy established an elite school for the top 1% of its pilots. Its purpose was to teach the lost art of aerial combat and to ensure the handful of men who graduated were the best fighter pilots in the world. They succeeded. Today, the Navy calls it Fighter's Weapons School. The Flyers call it Top Gun. The moment that tubular bell chimes and the text came on the screen in the opening of Top Gun, we were all transfixed. The first 4 minutes of the film are gripping. They show takeoffs and landings on an aircraft carrier, specifically the USS Enterprise. And I'd just come back from workups and had a one-day turnaround because a little Hollywood film wanted to shoot some authentic footage on an aircraft carrier. Director Tony Scott boarded, along with a few up-and-rising actors, and the USS Enterprise was one of the first nuclear-powered aircraft carriers. And as you can imagine, a flight deck is a really dangerous environment. There is all of these rules and protocols for who can be on the deck, where you can walk, and of course, what you're wearing. You have to have on boots and a helmet and goggles. And you can imagine the surprise of the crew when one of these up-and-coming actors shows up on the flight deck in a tank top and flip-flops to check it out and get some sun. I know what you're thinking, it's Tom Cruise, right? No, Val Kilmer. And we know this because one of our Broad Street concert band members was serving on the USS Enterprise during filming. You can see him in a yellow shirt and green helmet between 3 minutes and 18 seconds and 3 minutes and 28 seconds in the movie. Our very own Barry Sax player, Commander Rick Price, worked on the catapult and arresting lock on the USS Enterprise. Arranged by Robert Smith. It includes a medley of the Top Gun anthem, Danger Zone, Take My Breath Away, and Mighty Wings. Richard, we have a need for speed.
Thank you. Wow.